Ahoy there, me hearties. This be Captain Silverhook, and you're listening to the Two Old Pirates podcast. Set sail for an open sea of stories, tales, and some really crazy stuff. I expect you to like and subscribe, lest you be walking the plank. Ha ha ha!
Hello and welcome to Podcast 48. It's Eric with the Two Old Pirates, and I'm sorry that it took 2 weeks to get this up and going, but lots been going on. But we're here, we're back, and we're ready to go. This is going to be a short episode. I'm going to tell you a real quick true story, 100% true story, because I haven't done one of those in quite a while. And then I'm also going to go ahead and ruin a song for you. All right, so this one first starts in 1993, in the summer of 93. A friend of mine's sister was going to be going to Texas A&M College Station. She asked me, she said, hey, do you have anything going on? Would you like to go ahead and come up and help me move into the dorm? I said, sure, that's fine. So we drove up, you know, a good little ride and stuff, and just talked and got along. We were friendly and got everything moved into her dorm. And it was just a regular day, it seemed. there's a famous place right across the street, just down the road from where her dorm was. And it's the world famous Dixie Chicken. And the Dixie Chicken is a very, very famous watering hole that a lot of Aggies like to go drink at and socialize. And so she said, hey, do you want to get a soda or something? I was all sure. So I didn't see any convenience stores around. So we saw that Dixie Chicken. She said, hey, that's a real, real famous place. I said, we can go in there. We can see if we can get a Coke or Dr. Pepper or something. And so we both went in. Her name is Jennifer. And we went up and we ordered the drinks. And so she sat down, and as I turned around, I happened to see that there was a video game arcade system there, and it was the game Galaga. If you don't know anything about Galaga, it was a very, very popular game in the 80s, and it's my favorite game. So wherever I go, anytime that I see one of these standalone arcade Galaga machines, I always have to set the record. It's the one claim to fame that I have is that I'm really, really good at it. And so I said, what the hell, I'll go ahead and do it. So she's sipping on her drink and I'm sipping on my drink, and I go over there and I put a couple quarters up like in the old days, to save your spots. And I go through the first couple, games, and I'm just warming back up, because this is not a game that you play on an everyday basis in 1993, 10 years before, sure. So probably the second, maybe third game, I really got into my groove, and I already had the highest score. And, things are going on. There's nobody else in the place besides the people that were working behind the bar and me and Jennifer. And so I set the high score and I keep going. I'm feeling pretty good about myself. And then, of course, on the old video games, if you don't know, at the end of a game, you can go ahead and they give you three initials that you could put up for, like, the initials for you. And every single time that I ever set the highest score, if I was dating somebody at the time, I'd always put E for Eric, N for and then the girl's initial. So like in high school, I dated a girl named Valerie, so it's ENV, and or ENA for another girl that I dated, or there was a history there of dating people, so I usually put up their initials. So at this time I was single, and as I got the high score, I'm sitting there looking down at the three different places that you can go ahead and put, a letter. And I'm all like, well, I'm not dating anybody, so it's not gonna be EN something. That's all like, what could I do? And my sarcastic smart ass mind went straight to what would be the biggest, baddest thing to do at Texas A&M. You got it. I decided to put down U, a dash, and then T. Now, outside of Texas, if you don't know what I'm talking about, Texas A&M and the University of Texas have a massive rivalry that goes back, a century or more. Aggies don't like Longhorns, and Longhorns don't like Aggies, and that's just the way it's always been. So to have the drinking hole of A&M College Station be that disrespected with UT put on a video game was probably not the smartest thing I could have ever done. But if you look up, if you're outside of Texas, you know, A&M and UT are the two biggest things. And actually, Aggies won't even call it UT. They call it TU. They call it Texas University, and they call them T-Sippers. And there's a whole thing. It's some of it, if you're out of state, you'd find it very juvenile and very immature. But there's a lot of I don't want to say anger, but there's a lot of division between the two schools, and they really, really get up for playing each other. So there's a lot of animosity, let's put it that way. So I put UT, and then you're supposed to hit the fire button for it to register on the game. So I hit the fire button, and then it goes, and it shows number one, U-T, and then the other ones that were down there. And I think I had like number three and number four, you know, from the two previous quarters. But I hadn't really put anything in. I just felt like ECD for my initials and stuff. But on this one, if I get the high score, I've got to go ahead and do this. So I put UT. I felt pretty good about myself. And then out of nowhere, I started getting this feeling that there was somebody like over my shoulder. And I started to turn back, and I looked, and there was about a 6'4", 6'5", big dude wearing A&M stuff sitting right here. I look back, and there's a little bit shorter but pretty buff guy, about 6'3", wearing A&M stuff. Now, I'm not wearing any UT stuff because I wasn't even a fan of UT. I did it as a joke. And I hear the bigger guy on my right side say, "Are you stupid?" And I'm like, "What, sir?" You know. And he's all like, "You come into the Dixie Chicken. This is like the place to go for Aggies, and you dare put UT on our video game?" And then I had to decide, do I want to get curb stomped and beat up by these two corn-fed huge Aggies and thrown out of this place, or do I want to go and push my luck and see if I can go and get away with a little of a bit of a intelligence? So I played dumb, and I said, I'm not sure what you're talking about. I don't understand. Jennifer is sitting over at the table. She can kind of hear the conversation, and she's turned the other way because she knows Eric's about to have his ass beat. And so the guy says, "Are you serious? You really don't know what we're talking about. This is Texas A&M, College Station, and you put UT?" I said, "Sir, I don't know what you're talking about." And he's all, "UT, you put UT. That stands for University of Texas." And then I got that look on my face. Oh my God. I didn't even think of that. Oh my God, I am so sorry if I've offended you being here at A&M. I just helped my friend over there, and I pointed to her. I said, I just helped her get into her dorm. I would never have thought of doing something that asinine that I'd put the initials to such a big rivalry. Oh no, my name is Ulysses Thompson. And that big boy to my right looked at me. I looked over at the guy and said, "I'm serious." And then they're like, "Do you have any ID?" I said, "No, I left it in the car outside." But why would I do something like that? That would be stupid to come on your territory. And I don't even go to UT and put in UT. No, that's my name. And the big guy thought about it for a second. He's all like, "That's one of the craziest stories I've ever heard. But I think only a stupid man would do something like that. Good luck on the high score, man. Take it easy." And patted me on the back pretty hard, and the other guy patted me on the back, and I looked at Jennifer. I started walking towards the door, and then I busted ass and got out of there, and she followed me, and I walked at a very, very quick pace all the way back to where her dorm was, and her car was parked. I said, "Let's leave immediately before these two guys figure out that I did put UT because it's for University of Texas." I only did it to be a smart ass, but that's an honest to God true story about how Eric DeWolf almost met his demise at a very young age by doing something very, very stupid on a very, very hallowed ground area for Aggie. So any Aggie fans out there, any Aggie graduates, any Aggie alumni, anything like that, I didn't do it as a, yeah, I did. Yeah, I did it to be a smartass. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. I was young and dumb, and I'm just glad I didn't die that day. So I know that some people have been saying, "Hey, you haven't put up any true stories lately." That's 100% true story of when I went into the Dixie Chicken, got the high score on the video game there, and put UT for all people to be able to see. I probably don't think it lasted very long. The owners probably came by and unplugged it and reset the score, because having UT as the, you know, as the high score at A&M is not something that sounds really all that great. part two on this podcast is going to be how I ruin a song. All right. There was a song that came out in 1984 and it was a top 10 hit here in the United States. And it was a number one hit all across the world. There was multiple countries it was number one in, multi-platinum selling. And it was by a band called Frankie Goes to Hollywood, which was a techno band, kind of like Depeche Mode or something like that, New Order. And this is basically their biggest hit in the United States. And it was called Relax. And so when you're 11 or 12 and you're hearing this song on the radio, it's a dance song. It makes you want to get up and dance and stuff. It's got a really good beat to it. And I had listened to it, excuse me, for, you know, years and years and years. And then sometime, I would say in my 40s, I actually heard the Holly Johnson, who was the writer of the song and the lead singer of the band, explaining what the song was about. And it's one of those songs that when you say the words and sing it out loud and you're not really paying attention to the meaning and you're not actually having that mindset of what is behind these words, you can get lost in the idea of what the lyrics really mean. You know, we did that with Imagine by John Lennon, and we did that with some other songs earlier in some of the other episodes that, you know, you're singing along for years and you don't really know what it's about. And then when Holly Johnson explained what it was about, I felt kind of dirty. I felt kind of used in a way, because, you know, this is something that a lot of people had cranked up and listened to and they never really knew what it was about. So I'm going to go ahead and let you listen to that for a second. This is going to be a small piece of Frankie Goes to Hollywood, Relax. When you want a second to wait, relax, don't do it. When you want to come. Okay, now that you've been able to see the video and hear it, the song is about homosexual sex. Holly Johnson was a homosexual male, and he explains that in the song, he's trying to tell the person that he's having relations with to relax. Don't do it when you wanna. And we're gonna leave it at that because the song was ruined for me after that. Not that it's bad or anything. It's just I wasn't thinking it dealt with that at all about stuff. But yeah, it's a song about relations and relaxing so that something won't happen. I don't really male, female, doesn't matter. I don't really like enjoy talking about stuff like this, but this song has been around for 37, 38 years. And there's millions of people that have listened to this song and they probably were in the same boat that I was, that it was just a really good song about relax. Don't do it when you want to go to it, relax. And it was, it was a song about relations and not arriving at the moment too soon. I hope that you enjoyed episode 48. It's not very, very long. I tried to keep it under 10, about 15 minutes. I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that you guys will share this. I hope that we can get some more listeners. We're over 500 now, and I'm sorry that it took so long to get this out. But please like, subscribe, share, get it to your family. Get them into this, and let's go ahead and build this as we get closer to our second anniversary, which will be coming up, I believe, October 1st, and we'll have a special second anniversary special. So, for the Tool Pirates, this is Eric signing off. Peace, love, and be careful out there.